Hi guys, welcome back. So before we start today's video, I just wanted to say a huge thank you to all of you for helping me reach 1,000 subscribers. It's a very important milestone for me and I wouldn't have been able to do it without all of your love and support. So for today's video, we're going to go back to one of my most popular and most requested series and make a second part to it. We're going to start a new quiet book today, and this one is going to be more of a travel or an activity book. It's great to keep kids busy either on long road trips or on flights. So let's get started. So before we get started, I'm just going to quickly take you through how we created the pages for the quiet book. If you want a video tutorial, I'm linking it in the description box as well as in the iCard section right now. I did the exactly same pattern for my previous quiet book, except I've made a couple of tweaks which I'll explain to you now. So instead of using cardboard inside my quiet book pages this time, I found this really nice foam material. It's like a really thin paper, but it has an almost foam like finish, and I've stacked two papers into each of these, so that gives it a good thickness, plus the pages are really soft. For each of the pages of my quiet book, I've used Kartopu viscose, and this is a really lovely yarn. It's almost like a nylon thread, and here are the details of the yarn. So this is the only yarn that I've used consistently through all the pages. All other pieces that I've created are just with scrap supplies that I've had with me. Also, there are two ways of creating the quiet book pages. Either you can make two equal squares and stitch them together, or you can make one long rectangle, put the papers inside and fold it in half. So I'll just quickly show you the measurements of the page. This is about 24 centimeters by 24 centimeters. The way I made these pages are, I made a long bit and then I folded it in half. So I started with an initial chain of 36, and then from the second chain from the hook, I started half double crocheting. At the end of each row, I chained one, turned, and half double crocheted again. So for our first page, we're going to be making a tic-tac-toe or a cross and zero board. So for our very first page, I'm going to be using some scrap yarn that I have. These are just those regular craft store yarns, the non-branded ones that you can find. You can use any yarn you want. We're going to start with a slip knot. Insert your hook and tighten. And now you're going to make a chain of 32. So yarn over, pull through, and do this 32 times. So now I'm just going to quickly measure my chain of 32. It comes, if I stretch it out, to about 20 centimeters. Now from the second chain from the hook, so we're going to leave this chain, go into this one right here, we're going to place a half double crochet. Yarn over, insert your hook into the second stitch, pull up a loop. You have three loops on the hook. Now pull through all three. Into the next one, again place a half double crochet, and you're going to place one half double crochet all the way around until the end of this row. Now once you're done with this row, you should have a long piece that looks something like this. Now we're going to slip stitch back into this very first stitch to complete the row, and then leave a really long tail for sewing in. So I'm going to leave about this much. Snip the yarn and just pull it through. Now you can just tighten the ends, and this completes your first piece. Now go ahead and create three more pieces just identical to this to have a total of four. So now we're going to start with the first steam, and the first steam is going to be the heart steam. So I'm using some scrap yellow yarn, and with this we're going to start with a magic ring. So hold the yarn in your fingers and cross it across to create an X. Insert your hook into the bottom. I'm still using the 3.75 millimeter hook. So you insert your hook into the bottom, pick up the top and twist, and now pull up a loop. This creates your magic ring. Now you're going to start with a chain of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And into this magic ring, you're going to place 3 triple crochets. Yarn over twice. Insert your hook into the ring. Pull up a loop. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. That's 1. Again. 2. And one more time. 4, 3. Now into the same magic ring, you're going to place 3 double crochets. So to place a double crochet, you're just going to yarn over, insert your hook, pick up a loop. You have 3 on the hook, pull through 2, pull through 2. So I've made 2 of these, and now I'm going to make my third one right here. Now you're going to chain 1 and place 1 triple crochet back into the ring again. Now you're going to chain 1 again, place 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, followed by 3 triple crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Now you're going to chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and just tighten your magic ring. Now you're going to slip stitch into the middle. So insert your hook and then just pull through. Leave a tail. Snip your yarn off and fasten off. And you have a little heart ready. Now you can just sew in the ends. Now team 2 is going to be our circles team, and I'm using some scrap green yarn for this. So again, you're going to create a magic ring. And into this magic ring, you're going to place 6 single crochets. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now you're just going to tuck the tail to close your magic ring. And for the second row, you're going to place an increase or 2 single crochets in each stitch. So into the first one, we have 1 and 2. Into the one after that again, 1 and 2. Into the next one, 1 and 2. And continue this all the way around until you have 12 stitches for this row. Now for row 3, you're going to place 1 single crochet followed by an increase. So 1 on the first stitch, 2 on the next one, 1 and 2. Again, 1 on the stitch after that, 1, 2, until you have 18 stitches for this row. Now, once you're done with your 18 stitches, you're just going to slip stitch onto the very next stitch, leave a tail, snip your yarn off, and pull through. And that creates your first circle. Now, go ahead and create 4 more circles exactly like this one. So now that I have all of these pieces done, I'm just going to show you how we'll put it together. So we're going to put 2 of the pieces vertically like this, and then 2 of the pieces horizontally like this. I'll show you how to sew on one of these pieces. So I've threaded on one of the pieces, and I'm first going to place it exactly where I want it to go. And then I'm just going to go inside the stitches and do a simple stitch around. So I'm going under the pink stitches and then over the black. So then none of the extra sides are visible. Like this. So you're going to continue this all the way around. So this is what the final page looks like. Now, I'm just going to go to the adjacent page. So the book is going to be like this, and I'm going to be using the back side of this page, the page that is facing this one. And in this page, I'm going to make two pockets for my pieces, one for the hearts and one for the circles. So now I'm going to be using this scrap white yarn to make my pockets, and I'm going to be using a 3.75 millimeter crochet hook. To get started, create a slip knot, insert your hook and tighten, and now you're going to start with a chain of 13. Now you're going to go into the second chain from the hook. So skip this one, go into this one and place a half double crochet. Yarn over, insert your hook into the second stitch, pull up a loop, you have three on the hook, pull through all three, and then go on placing one half double crochet on each of the stitches until the end of this row. So now once you're done with this row, chain one, turn your work and continue placing one half double crochet all the way around until the end. And this is the pattern you're going to follow for the next five rows. So for the next five rows, chain one, turn and place one half double crochet all the way around until the end and make two pockets that look like this. So once you finish your two pockets, meet me back here again. So now I've created these two pockets and I'm going to place one on top and then one diagonal to that. And then on each of these, I've made an extra heart and an extra circle to place on top. So I'm going to sew these together and show you how it looks. So now I have my two pockets with the two pieces on them. Into the one with the hearts, we can put all the little hearts. And into the one with the circles, all the little circles. Now whenever you want to play, you can just pull out the pieces and play. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like it, share it with all your friends and subscribe to my channel. Part 2 of The Quiet Book will be out in a week, so stay tuned for that too. Until next time, bye-bye!